The following production is part of the We Be Geeks podcast collective.
All this has happened before.
Hey kids, Townsend Coleman here, the voice of Michelangelo from the original Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Tom Kane, this is the voice of Yoda on Star Wars.
Hey yo, it's Wopat, and a big yee-haw to you all. I used to be Luke too.
Hi, my name is Oli Shoshan. I play Jedi Master Shakti.
Hi, Butch Patrick here, Eddie Munster.
Hi, this is Jim.
Hi, this is Bill Farmer. You're listening to the Neverland Podcast.
Welcome to Neverland, to Disney and beyond.
And it will all happen again.
And now your head lost boy, the Spider-Pan.
Walk on the eyes, it is Pan.
Jeremy.
Hooray for Captain Pan!
All right, thanks for that lovely introduction, because, hey, I've actually got a guy that I knew, this guy Wiley. He did that intro for me, gives me my name. But you know what? I still got to start the show, although I've discussed with Heather, saying, do I need to drop this? But I don't know, send me an email if you think I should drop this. But take a pixie out of your pocket, sprinkle that pixie dust around, think that happiest thought, and I'm going to burp. And I burped, and I flew to Neverland on the power of the burp. That's right, because burps make me happy. And I'm here with Lost Boy Philip, and he's losing it now. My introduction went totally south of the winter. And it's springtime, so it's not coming back after winter. So I don't know what I'm saying. Hi, thanks for listening, aren't you? You're so happy you downloaded this. Hey, you paid for it. It was free. You got what you paid for.
That's right.
There you go. But yeah, this week's show was a disaster to get together. Because I was trying, I had these great plans, you know, we had fun playing the Disney, well, Disney, I'm going to put in quotes, Trivial Pursuit with Eric, and we still had fun playing. I got creamed pretty well. Tracy from Disney, Indiana, won that pretty handily, I'd say. She knows her trivia. But, of course, there was only a few Disney questions, and the only questions I really got right were the Disney questions. This week we were going to play some Star Wars Trivial Pursuit. I had things just didn't quite get together where I could get everybody together to play the game. But I wanted to do something special because it's May the 4th is Tuesday. It is officially Star Wars Day. May is a big month for Star Wars anyway, I mean, because, you know, May 25th. I'm rather fond of May 26th myself, but, I mean, I'm getting older. I mean, I'm going to be, what, 43? I feel like Jack Nicholson somehow. So I'm getting old, but that's what we're going to play, have some Star Wars fun, and the only thing we planned is we're gonna quiz each other a little bit on some questions. We might have some random stuff because Philip and I are random.
Yes, we are.
But I want to tell everybody. So I have a couple of YouTube channels. If you look up The Spider-Pan, you will find my personal channel. I have streamed a few games there, but mainly this week because I'm still playing the heck out of Final Fantasy VII. The remake.
And how's that going?
Oh, golly, it's such a great game. It's so much fun. And I've been going and playing it. I've done a second playthrough I started on easy because I'm just trying to level up characters because I do want to try to play it on hard. Although I'm getting slightly distracted from that. I'll have to get into that. But I've been live streaming. If you look on YouTube at Neverland to Disney and Beyond, yes, we have a YouTube channel. And I've been streaming some games even on our Facebook page. If you look for our Facebook page, if you haven't already joined it, live streaming some games, having some fun. I haven't set a very good schedule on it, but I've tried it like nearly every day, at least 3 days a week, put up some game footage or play live with people. And you actually get to see my face, which I'm sorry. But you get to see me as I'm playing, and I, you know, kind of talk as I play. Well, I got noticed by the people over at Streaming the Magic, which I've talked to them before and everything when they were getting started. I wish I could have done more with them because they like to get annual pass holders to walk through Disney parks and do things and stream it for a couple hours on YouTube. Fun idea. Well, they decided that they contacted me and asked if I had some Disney games to stream. And I was like, have I? Sure, I'll play Disney games and stream them. And that will begin Monday. I'm going to aim for about 2 o'clock Central. I got a few technical details to work out. I'm planning to play on the PS4. I have purchased the... Now, there is a DuckTales remaster, and I do own that on a PS3, but I don't have a way to stream my PS3. But my PS4, I can remote play on the computer. I've worked out stuff where I can stream stuff, and I've been doing it. But I can play the original NES DuckTales Rescue Rangers. They had a collection they put out of all the 90s Nintendo games.
Awesome.
I'm terrible at them, but I'm going to stream it tomorrow. And because I love them, May the 4th will be Tuesday. I've decided, because I own all the Lego
stuff. May the 4th is tomorrow.
Is it tomorrow?
Yeah.
Oh, my golly. Okay, so tomorrow then, May the 4th, I'm going to play Lego Star Wars in some fashion. I own a lot of them, and I actually, on my Xbox, I have the complete saga version. On the computer I had, like, when they did the first one was just prequels, then I did the second one that was the original trilogy. I have those for the computer, but I'm planning to play Lego Star Wars. And tomorrow being May the 4th, because I just realized it's Sunday, May 3rd. So I'm going to play some Lego Star Wars. So that will be the first stream, but we will play stuff like DuckTales and Rescue Rangers. Woo! I'll try to play Darkwing Duck, but I'll be honest, I cannot get through the first level of the Darkwing Duck NES game. It plays like a Mega Man game, and I'm awful at Mega Man.
Well, you know it's supposed to, because let's get dangerous.
And it's dangerous. I cannot get through that first level, I will be perfectly honest. And I've only completed the DuckTales game with the remastered, which I love the remastered with the voices and the animation. Oh, it's a beautiful game for the PS3. I do love it. But so that will be starting the Monday. And yeah, since that will be Star Wars Day, I'm going to play some Lego Star Wars then.
There you go.
Rock on, and probably for like an hour, 2 hours. And we're just going to have a good time. I'm going to try not to worry about collecting all the studs like I normally would. I'm just going to try to play through and see how much story I can get through. So that is the plan tomorrow. It'll be my first time streaming the Magic. I'm not sure what the plan, if they want me to do something every day, because I would still like to keep playing Final Fantasy VII. I'm being distracted enough, because here's the other fun thing. This is what's fun to own a Switch. I finally got my Switch back out and got it hooked up after moving in. And so I started playing Stardew Valley again, and so I'm getting all hooked into that. I want to play Animal Crossing, because I see, like, Adrian Ropp, of those of you who might be familiar with him, you know, we had him as a guest at Comic-Con. He was an artist with Disney. He did all the storyboards for, like, Disney Infinity. Great artist. Has drawn Pink Panther, Underdog for, awesome, for different companies. I think he's currently I know he's done work with Archie. I don't know if he's still drawing some Archie comics. But, I mean, awesome, he's done a lot of stuff. He's a really cool guy. And Eric has known him since they were kids, apparently. So, about as long as I've known you, Phil.
Yeah.
So, they've known each other for a long time, but what was my point? Oh, yeah, he's playing Animal Crossing. I believe Eric is playing Animal Crossing on the Switch. I'm the only one not playing, and I want to play with those guys, because I've seen footage, and you can play online and visit each other's little islands. It looks a lot of fun. It's cute. It's Stardew Valley, I think, ripped off Animal Crossing a little bit, and I do love Stardew Valley. But anyway, so I got distracted playing that. But while I was, like, looking at things, you know, what's new in the Nintendo shop, it's like $3, and you get your subscription to Nintendo, but that lets you play online. It's a lot cheaper than on the PlayStation Network. But this also gives me access to a program that I have a bunch of old Nintendo games on. And I've enjoyed that, getting to play classic Nintendo games on my Switch. But I don't know when this happened. I just saw it this week. Super Nintendo is now part of my subscription. And Super Metroid, The Legend of Zelda, Link to the Past, all kinds of great classics. Super Nintendo, mainly the Nintendo-made ones, but
yeah,
lots of Super Nintendo games, even Mario Kart, and I haven't played the original Kart in so long.
That was my favorite.
Oh, so I had to play that yesterday. So I'm going to come back and play some more Final Fantasy VII Remake, because I do love it, but Mario Kart.
Those are my favorites.
I love it. You're gonna have to come over sometime. Yep. Now we're kind of lifting restrictions in Missouri. Seth would probably say we're asking for death or something. So I won't even get into he's very concerned. We'll just say he's very concerned. But you know, we're trying to open the state back up. I know neither one of us seem to be sick, so I'm comfortable with you coming over to play sometime this week or something.
Yeah.
Anyway. But yeah, so those of you with a Nintendo Switch, I do recommend getting your Nintendo subscription account so you can play Super Nintendo games, because it will distract you away from playing everything else you're supposed to play. I wish I could live stream from my Nintendo, but I can't do that yet.
Yeah.
I need to get some other devices that I would be able to hook it up to the computer and do some things, but that's expensive. So I'm going to take a drink. So I mean, what have you been doing while you've been quarantined?
Well, mostly studying. I study a lot.
Good time to do it.
Yeah, been reading a lot and watching shows. Watching shows. It's a time. If you have any TV shows and all that, I'm sure you've been doing the same. Most of y'all, you know, just catching up. And that's something I've done a lot of. Mostly studying. I study a lot. I read a lot.
Yeah, we need to get back on Picard. Okay, yeah, my wife is just testing to tell me that she's at home. I knew she was at home. Where was she going to go? Yeah, we need to get back to watching Picard. We kind of had this.
That's a good show.
You probably got to finish it.
I did. I watched them all. But I'll watch them again.
Yeah, of course you will.
I was thinking about watching them again. They're fun.
Also, oh, Disney Plus. I'm only up through 5 episodes of the new Clone Wars season, though.
I'm going to watch them all. I've only gotten to watch 2 of them. I want to watch them again.
So far, the ones that were the best were those first 4 of the 5 I've watched. 5 disappointed me. It kind of broke my heart because it was a return of Ahsoka. It's Ahsoka coming back, but the episode is not very good.
Don't say anything. I don't want to know. I don't want to know yet. Don't say anything.
But, oh, the Bad Batch you've already met, those guys were fun. They were like the A-team.
Yeah.
I really had fun with those episodes. And the 5th episode, I want so much more with Ahsoka. But Ahsoka's still around. Yes. Ahsoka deserves some great episodes. And I'm hoping further in the season it got better. But that 5th episode really disappointed me. I'm not going to tell you what happens, but that's the one where Ahsoka comes back. You get to see what she's doing. So, but speaking of some Star Wars, May the 4th. Mm-hmm. The 4th be with you. Now, some people are going to like, hey, May the 5th. But, yeah, hey, that's Cinco de Mayo. Let Mexico have it. Yeah. But I'd rather, in America, I don't care about Cinco de Mayo. I'm not from Mexico. I'm not Mexican. I don't need an excuse to eat tacos. By the way, Taco Tuesday is May the 5th. So, come on.
We'll take advantage of it.
I'm going to Taco Bell, brother.
Yeah.
Because that's what we do. That's what we do. So, if you want to have Revenge of the 5th, that's fine by me. I don't care. Some extra Star Wars days. I'm all good with that. But because of that, we want to do some Star Wars trivia. So I'm going to give you a short stack. Make sure these questions for the answers, of course, are on the back. So make sure I can't see the back when you're answering me. Ask me a question. We're going to go back and forth and just ask some questions. I'm just going to grab some random stacks. We probably won't get through all these. Free Comic Book Day was supposed to have been yesterday. Mm-hmm. We were supposed to also have that Black Widow movie out. It's all been postponed. So it ruins my normally fun weekend, and normally it was a great podcast episode, in my opinion. Hopefully y'all enjoy when I do this, but we go out there and record and have a good time getting some free comics. Usually get to see a fun Marvel movie, and this year it's just a little bit postponed. But I'm still excited for this Black Widow movie whenever it gets to come out.
Yep, I can't wait to see it.
We are going to ask each other some Star Wars trivia questions. And see, we might have random conversations that suddenly happen in the middle of trying to ask other questions. But I'll let you ask me, and with the questions, of course, we can go down each one of these categories per card, so we can burn these cards up. Well, no, don't burn them. I want to be able to play the game later. These are from a Trivial Pursuit Saga Edition DVD game that I have. So it's got, like, some of the questions would be on a DVD even, that I've only really gotten to play once because I beat my wife. No, okay, that's, I won in a game against...
You defeated her.
that sounded so bad. Y'all know that I love the bio nerd, the Wendy nerd, as I also call her in this show. Y'all love her to death. Uh-oh, no, that doesn't sound bad, too. No, okay, I said that one on purpose to be funny.
All right. Yeah, you love her so much.
But I won, and so she has never wanted to play with this with me again, because I knew some weird, stupid, obscure things that she didn't know how I knew that.
Sure you're going to beat me on this.
I don't know. Well... you've had problems with losing some of your rental facilities at points, but there are stuff that you never forget.
Some things.
You know, I can forget my name and still remember a stupid Mickey Mouse detail probably, you know, at this point.
Oh, I'm not great at some of these things.
But they have different categories, though, on these cards. And I have used these at the UCM. We actually played some Star Wars trivia for some prizes.
And what are the categories?
I don't know what they all mean, but one says can, one says farce, one says... It's probably force. Canada. There's questions about Canada because Canada is a planet in the Star Wars galaxy. One's probably a force one. Hey, you know what? I don't want to open the box. It's way over there. But there are different categories that normally in Trivial Pursuit you'd land on a color. You'd get a question of that color, right? So we'll just we don't have to go through that many cards. But so and you play along at home because if you happen to be at work. Yeah. Consider yourself blessed. You're still working because I'm furloughed and I'm not getting to go to work. Although I'm finding ways to create. And that's my recommendation. If you happen to be furloughed or you're stuck at home, find something creative or something to do. It does, I think, really help to be able to create. I'm live streaming, making videos and stuff onto the YouTube and doing stuff I really needed to be doing the whole time. But now I find myself with time. Plus, with a new house, we've been out gardening. My sense of gardening is to go and buy a bunch of Mickey Mouse figures and put them all over the front yard. So that's what I've done. But anyways, ask me a question and I will try to answer it.
And I'll take... I think we should take a few moments, just a few moments, and see if they know it.
Give them a chance to answer. Yeah.
To at least do
themselves. Well, I have to have time to think.
Yeah. What does the Dagobah swamp creature swallow and then spit out?
And with a lot of language in this scene, I mean, there's a lot of foul language that's all bleeped out. And there's some screaming and bleeping, because R2-D2 has the foulest mouth in the entire galaxy.
That's true.
And he's what got swallowed by a big old creature and spit right out. And he's lucky he doesn't taste very good.
That's true. Exactly right.
Indeedy. Now, I'll ask you a question.
Well, go ahead.
Hopefully we'll get some harder questions. That was too easy.
Yes.
Who prepares a tasty root leaf stew for an off-world visitor? He's pausing for silence and effect.
I assume it's Yoda.
Indeed. I cook. Which, for the longest time, I couldn't understand what he was saying there until I actually watched it with subtitles. I'm like, oh, root leaf, I cook.
Yeah. I didn't know that he was saying root leaf for a long, long time.
Yeah. Because we've never heard of a root leaf.
Yeah.
Roots don't have leaves.
Yeah. Well, that's okay. Over there, they might.
It might be just what they call that kind of stew. It's a roots with leaves. And yeah, on Dagobah, that's all you got is, you know, swamp water with some roots and leaves in it. Maybe a weird something similar to a
combination of things.
Combination. Who knows what... Well, considering what we've seen with what we call baby Yoda and eating these frog-like things, who knows what full-grown Yoda would dare to consume.
That's right. Since we're on that, I'll just tell you. I don't know what it is that Luke's supposed to be eating, those little rolls or whatever.
Nutrition bars or something.
I'll tell you what. My friend used to make these, I guess, taquito rolls or whatever. I used to call them Yoda snacks. Because that's exactly what, you know, Yoda snacks, because that's what it looks like.
I never thought of that.
It looks a lot like what Luke is eating on Dagobah. So that's what I call Yoda snacks. Yeah. They're like Yoda snacks.
How you can get so big eating food of this kind?
Oh, they're not bad.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, see, now I got to eat a taquito.
Yeah.
Dude, 5th of May, Revenge of the 5th, taquitos. And we're going to call them Yoda snacks.
That's it, Yoda snacks.
There you go, brother. It's on.
There you go.
It's on.
Now you know.
Oh, wow. Okay. All right. What? I got to ask you a question.
You already did.
Did I?
Yeah, that's about...
I got confused.
There you go.
It is my turn to answer the question now. Okay.
What does Darth Maul control using a wristband comlink?
Oh, they're like the droids that he had. They were like... I don't know if they would consider like a type of a probe droid, but they sensed that they were looking for stuff.
Sith probe droids. You had it just right.
Awesome sauce. I probably answered it too soon. But, you know, if you knew the answer, you answered it when I didn't. If you didn't answer it when I did, I'm sorry. Well, you didn't think about it, but you probably... These are not difficult.
Not yet.
I don't find these... Well, then again, we're Star Wars nerds, so they're not difficult for us. But if you're listening to this show, you probably are too. You're one of us, and we embrace you fully.
You probably are too and get swallowed up by it.
There you go. You are too, and we see your 3PO. We should really put that away.
You do too?
We BB your 8. I don't know.
Oh, come on now.
I don't know what that meant. We ate your BB? I don't know. Oh, that sounds like we ate your baby. I'm sorry. I'm saying so many terrible things today. That's the sound of 1,000 terrible things coming out of my mouth. Oh, heading this way.
Terry.
Oh, wow. Hey, you paid for it. It was a free show. Alrighty. Who happens to be tethered to Jango Fett when he boots the bounty hunter off a slippery ledge?
Say it again.
Who happens to be tethered to Jango Fett when he boots the bounty hunter off a slippery ledge?
I know it's Obi-Wan, isn't it?
Yeah, yes. I didn't understand the question. Yeah, I had to look it up to get. But yeah, so who is, you know, tethered to when somebody booted Jango Fett off, and it's like, whoops, I'm tethered to him, because yeah.
Yeah, he's still tied to the situation. Episode
2. Episode 2. And, you know, this was actually something I was talking, you know, I was having some fun with a good old Eric. His wife.
Been?
I guess he's doing good. He's enjoying some time with his family. He had a successful trip to go buy toilet paper. But I guess his wife Haley hadn't seen really all the Star Wars movies and really hadn't showed that much interest. But she started to watch because he wanted to watch, and he's going for it. This month he wants to watch the entire saga. Good. And I'm talking every movie, every TV show. Everything. Rogue One. I think he's going to go for the because he loves the Ewoks movies too. I'm go for it, Eric, man, do it. But so he was with Hayden last night, but we were kind of talking, you know, I was on Facebook, him and even Adrian Rapp and everything, and I had mentioned, it's like, well, he found this really fun meme where somebody had taken Anakin's little fit there on Tatooine in episode 2, that and I love all of them, even the prequels and the sequels. And, you know, and it's really funny. And I said, like, you know, the thing is with Star Wars is Star Wars, as I always say, Star Wars is like pizza. Even when it's bad, it's still Star Wars.
Yeah, even if it's bad, it's still pizza.
So, and then Adrian was like, I do not know of this bad Star Wars of which you speak. And of course, I mentioned, you know, it's like, well, you know, if you take half the last Jedi that could have been avoided if they'd had a good staff meeting, and if we could have just dropped the whole concept of love story, because the good part of the Attack of the Clones is the mystery with Obi-Wan and going finding out what this clone army, where it's coming from, and his fight with Jango Fett was amazing, because we see what Boba Fett should have maybe we got to see of him, but we didn't get a chance to see what he's capable of. But we know what Boba Fett is capable of thanks to what Jango was doing in that fight with Obi-Wan. It's like, dude, he's holding his own with a Jedi.
Yeah,
until he meets awesome. Mace Windu, and I feel like we could have used that character a little longer.
Yeah,
you know, because he was such a but he went down hard, man. Because Mace Windu, brother.
Yeah, he's pretty good.
Because he's Samuel L. Jackson. We didn't have to see much out of Mace Windu because it was Samuel L. Jackson. We knew he was awesome.
That's right.
That's it. He's Samuel Jackson.
It's one of the reasons why I love the first animated.
Oh, yes, Lord. The Gendy Tartakovsky.
I love it.
Love that episode, especially with the kid with the water. Yeah. That's just adorable.
It's supposed to be the Coca-Cola, like.
Yeah, with the one, the Willie Joe Namath, wasn't it? Yes.
No, it wasn't Willie Joe Namath.
Wasn't it Joe Namath?
I can't think of his name right now.
It was a football player, though. Yep. Yeah, but yeah, I love that little bit there. And then Mace Windu jumps back into the attack.
Can't think of his name, one of the great African-American football players of the 1970s. I can't think of his name right now.
That is a great episode.
Yeah, anyway.
Doc Johnson. That's a whole different thing.
Not, anyway, I can't think of his name.
Alrighty, so it's time for to ask me a question.
Okay, sorry about that. Went all crazy.
That's all right. That's making the show good.
The drop on Obi-Wan's starfighter... after navigating through the center of an asteroid.
Jango Fett again.
There we go. See, we're just
blast is why I hate flying.
That's right.
And that, you know, that's an interesting scene, because I remember when I first saw it in theaters, I was like, why is there no music in this?
Yeah.
And I've always felt I wanted to criticize that. But then I didn't think about it, but another great podcast with David W. Collins, who has worked, and he's done music for like some Star Wars games, all kinds, you know, but he's a big Star Wars guy and big music guy. I mean... But he's got great podcasts on soundtracks, the Soundtrack Show, and he even appeared on Rebel Force Radio, going through the Star Wars soundtracks. And he points out that there's a lot of music that was composed for Empire that they chose to not use because the sound design was so amazing.
Yeah.
And I never really thought about it. Like some scenes that there's just no music, but
I have
the sounds. But that's what they were doing in Episode 2, because that sound of that. Those mines was really kind of cool.
There was. There's a lot of this extra.
So they wanted you to hear that sound, and I appreciate that a lot more now. Thinking about it, it's like they didn't put music because the sound was so wild.
It was almost its own music in a sense.
Yeah.
It was the thing is the music is its own character.
Yes, and it's John Williams.
You don't want. Oh man, John Williams. In my opinion, he's the best.
I'm gonna get you sidetracked if I go.
He's his own great.
So what you were saying though before I said John Williams?
No, I said I don't remember what I was gonna say except that
the sound effects are like a music themselves.
To themselves, and I was saying that in a way you don't want to interrupt the music with the sound effects, but you don't want to interrupt the sound effects with the music. You don't want to. So I think it was really good that way. Oh, I know what I'm gonna say with the Empire Strikes Back. I actually have some Empire Strikes Back music on. That's not in the movie.
Yeah.
And
the original soundtrack release had a lot of that music
that's
in there.
What it was.
And you'd listen to it and you couldn't match it up to the movie. You wonder why. But then you watch really the scenes, you realize I have heard David W. Collins, the Soundtrack Show, y'all gotta check this out. He goes and he even did at the Star Wars convention. And I forgot what they call it. Wow. Yeah. It just went right. I was hoping you were going to help me with that. You don't know either. They do it every couple of years. And wow, my brain just went out the window. Star Wars Celebration. He did a panel once where he had inserted the music back on and showed the scenes with the music to show how different it was, but how much and how cool it is to have the John Williams music on there. But like how much
I've seen that.
How much you would not hear of all the fantastic sounds that they came up with. And I forgot who the sound designer on Star Wars films was, but I mean the guy was legendary though. Yeah. That sound designer, and he came up with such amazing
little
sounds.
Chords and,
all these different little sounds that just make the environment. Bigger. And you're just in it.
For Chewbacca's a bear and all this other
and
stuff.
All these different animals. Yes. And I'm coming up with sounds of lightsabers and laser blasts. And what is a room full of all these computers in a rebel base? What does a rebel base sound like? And you walk into that the Hoth base and you hear all these sounds.
I actually watched these. I can't remember what it was called right now.
I get excited. I'm going to watch Empire.
There's this horrible, horrible sci-fi film. I can't think of what it was called right now. They were trying to say they were before Star Wars because the guy had the idea for it. But it was really horrible. They actually used certain sound effects that came from Star Wars. They used it. And I'm surprised they didn't get sued, but they were so small that it didn't get.
Oh, golly.
Yeah, they actually used some. You can hear it in the background. You're like, okay, that's for Star Wars. That's for Star Wars. Yeah. You know?
Even like the first season of the Transformers cartoon, I would recognize sounds they got from the Star Wars library.
You know that's what it is.
Like the Decepticons would fly by and it sounded like a TIE fighter.
Yeah.
I'm like, yes, I love it, though. I love it.
Yeah, especially as a kid.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, is it your turn to ask?
Because I think I just answered Jango Fett for a thing.
Yeah, go ahead.
All right, so here's one for you. I have no idea what HVS means. All right, what character snores while asleep on Queen Amidala's ship?
I'm assuming it's Jar Jar.
That's a good assumption.
Yeah, because Chewbacca's not around yet.
Right.
So I'm assuming it's Jar Jar.
And I'm pretty sure, this would have been the overnight in the first, in episode one, Jar Jar asleep when it's just a poor snippet.
Yeah, because he's supposed to be funny. And that's supposed
you
to
know,
be
the
funny.
The first few times I watched it, Jar Jar, I laughed. He was funny. But he does get annoying after a while. But I still love that movie.
Yeah, I don't love the movie.
I think he gets crapped on more than it deserves because Liam Neeson.
No, listen. I think the movie's not good. But that being said, there are a couple good parts. There's only two great parts for me personally. And that is Liam Neeson and everything I've seen him in, I love.
Just because and Liam Neeson.
Liam Neeson is tremendous. Mm-hmm. I love the man. And dick that as you will. No, I love him. I think he's outstanding.
He's
and Darth Maul is outstanding.
Yeah.
He's a tremendous character.
Because you got to love Ray Park.
Oh, my gosh.
Ray Park. I'm glad he finally was getting the attention he deserved.
And I'm glad they brought him back. Darth Maul back. I mean, it's
kind of weird.
It's a stretch, but it's awesome, and I love it. And because he was one of those characters that before it came out, everyone was like, oh, man, he's going to be the new Darth Vader. Well, I didn't think he was ever going to be the new Darth Vader, but I wanted to see him.
He'd be somebody we'd be scared of.
And he was gone. He was gone in a flash. And
I was surprised by that.
And we didn't get to see him much. But it was okay because they're finding a way to plus which, and I'm sorry if you all have not seen the cartoon. I'm not trying to ruin anything. But I love that we get to have Clancy Brown be his brother, be a chance.
A SWAT.
Well, to me, you can't get better.
His name actually has an English meaning.
Is one of the greatest Kurgan. Villains of all time, and I love you, Clancy.
Clancy Brown is one of the greatest Kurgan, voices of all time.
I love him.
Whatever Clancy Brown does in awesome. Voice, we just love him. Yes, we do. Alrighty, time for me to answer your question.
I'm assuming this is Saga, SGA.
Yeah.
Who zaps an Ewok with an electric charge?
R2, it'll give you time to think of it too, but R2.
That's right in the rump, I believe.
Huh? Right in the rump, right in the furry jublets. Mm-hmm. I am being weird. All right, so here's a Saga question for you. Can I just say that I cheered a little bit in Rise of Skywalker in the theater when Wick gets there with his son?
His real son.
Yes, isn't that fantastic? I love that.
Warwick Davis's real
Warwick
son.
Warwick Davis's actual and son
cute
with
little
him.
Feller.
Oh,
he looked just like him too. He's a sweet little guy.
Yeah, I love. If you haven't watched the makings on Rise of Skywalker, you got to watch this because Warwick Davis and his son get to be wickedness. Oh,
yeah, that was awesome.
I'm gonna get beclempt. Let me ask you a question. No, wait a minute. Maybe you ask me a question. No, I'm asking you a question. Yes, I'm asking you a Saga question. Okay. Well, I loved that. By the way, anyway, that was a great moment. Who pilots the stolen Imperial shuttle away from the Rebel fleet?
I believe that's Han Solo.
Yeah, I'll take that one. I would have accepted Chewbacca, because that's when you've also got, I don't know, fly casual.
Well, that's right. That's
so, because,
right.
I mean, Chewbacca...
That's true.
Han Solo doesn't fly solo.
No, Han Solo.
See what I did there? Yeah, you got it. You got it.
Han Solo.
I would have taken... They don't list Chewbacca on the card, but I would have taken Chewbacca, because Chewbacca's the one trying to fly casual.
That's true. Because
and a stolen
I don't
casual.
Know.
Fly casual.
Yeah.
Chewie's pretty fast if they don't go for it. Yeah, you gotta love Chewie. Gotta love Chewie.
They're always gonna be my favorite. All right, the galaxy, I think it is GAL.
Probably.
What planet? Yeah, I'm assuming because it's about a planet. What planet's friendliness in Dexter's Jester's? I'm assuming.
Yeah.
Opinion,
Dexter Jester.
Yeah. Dexter's Jester's opinion depends on how good your manners are and how I'm big your pocketbooks
are. They're cloners.
That's all right.
Yeah. I know what planet you're talking about, but now I got to think of the name of the planet.
My favorite in that movie, as far as I think he's a cool guy.
He's a neat character.
I love him. I wanted to see him more, even though at the end with that smile, I thought he could have been bad. Just the way he went,
He know he's. So that's he's the thing. You always get the idea that he's been around, he's seen some stuff.
I really
like
him.
He may be centuries old.
I liked him.
Yeah, he was kind of just a neat character. Ah, they're cloners. Wow.
I like you, the robot.
I'm trying to think of the name of that planet because for some reason I can picture it—the reigning planet and the really kind of neat alien designs for other people who live there.
Yeah,
because it was removed from all star charts. I can tell you everything about the planet, but I'm trying to think of the name of the planet. For some reason, it's not coming to me.
Original Battlefront. I love it
that you could go to the planet,
and I love fighting. That was great.
Yes,
that was my favorite place to be.
That was cool. My top might have been maybe both versions of Cloud City.
Oh, that was awesome too. That was what
mainly because
right.
I loved being able to do that, circling the square before going down to the courtyard in Cloud City.
That's true. That was my
and favorite. That other one using jet troopers to hop over, where you had like that one battle hallway in the middle, and then you had all this other stuff.
I love that.
The Cloud City levels were great, but fighting out on. I want to say, but it's not Genovia. Wow, why is the name of this planet suddenly lost out of my... Calamari, no.
Calamari.
Mon Calamari is a race. It's where the cloning facilities are.
That's not that far. What you just said is not that far.
Yeah, it's... And I got people now yelling at their phones or radios or into their headphones if they get the opportunity to work, yelling the name Caminos.
That's right.
Because I remember, it's like El Camino.
That's the hardest.
They're cloners.
That's the hardest one you've had so far.
That shouldn't have been a hard question, though.
Yeah, but I didn't have it either.
I am so sorry. I embarrassed for myself.
I didn't have it either, man. But the moment I saw it, I was like, that's it! I knew it!
The planet names sometimes are difficult, but that was such a neat planet.
I loved it.
I mean, that's the music of that planet, man.
Yeah, that was neat.
Oh,
that was a great scene, that fight. Oh,
yes, out in the ranks. Like, we got to see what Boba Fett were probably capable of when we see what Jango could do.
I got to give kudos to the, especially for its time. You know, in 2002.
Yeah.
That was 18 years ago.
And oh, wow, we're old.
Yeah, 18 years ago. I know that because it was just a couple days ago. It was 18 years ago Maddie.
And I guess it was.
Was born, and that was.
It was right kind of before Heather and I got married, was that movie. Because I remember I was still living with my parents. So I wasn't married just yet.
That was.
Because Spider-Man 2 had just come out.
Yeah.
Even.
Yeah, Spider-Man 1 had just come out.
Was it the original Spider-Man? Because I remember they made a goof. Yeah, it was the Spider-Man 1 because they'd had to change the tower. But I remember they made a little goof on Yoda.
Yeah.
There with that. They put the Spider-Man text up. It's like, this summer, only one hero is the one to see. And they had it up in Spider-Man text. And then they showed Yoda where he pulls out that lightsaber with the Force. And like, oh, I see what you did there. So, but I was being a big Spider-Man fan. I was really excited for Spider-Man 2. I was like, oh, please don't poke up my Spider-Man, guys. Come on. I love Star Wars, but I love Spider-Man too. Maddie, your little niece was born.
Yeah, she was born 18 years ago, believe it or not.
18 years ago. My goodness.
Love her.
Graduating. Yeah. And to all you graduates, congratulations. Please, let's find a way to celebrate with y'all.
Yeah, we love you.
By the way, Tim Devine of ImageWorks, remember a couple weeks ago when he was on to talk about Final Fantasy? He is making some really neat yard signs, and he can put a photo into the yard sign, but it has to be an unlicensed photo, so you have to have taken the photo yourself. Go to ImageWorks.com and order yourself a really neat sign. He's a good guy. And I'm sure he'd be happy to send some orders and mail them out. It's been really successful because he's got a really neat yard sign design. So, if you've got a graduate, then support another Disney fan. So,
I think it's your time.
I believe it might be because I just struggled trying to get Camino. I don't know. Okay. This is a galaxy question, I guess. What twosome prepare for an underwater outing on Naboo by donning A99 Aquata breathers?
I believe we're talking about Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan.
I believe you are correct. I believe. Okay, I was going to the redneck tour. I believe. But it's an A99 Aquata breather. Just for reference, listen, see, that's how you learn those little details is when they ask a question, because you might not have, if they had asked what it was called.
Yeah.
Or that they used. I wouldn't have known A99, but here it is in the question, and now I know. And knowing is half the battle.
That's right.
Who
on earth would actually sit there and say, we're going to put these little things on them, and we're going to call it a...
an A99.
Yeah.
Somebody had to think of it. But how neat would that be if all you had was this little thing, and you'd have as much oxygen as you needed to go and swim all the way to Naboo? To Gunga City.
Yeah, Gunga. Okay. Who helps make a sale by noting that unit is in prime condition? A real bargain.
A real bargain. That would be... Y'all know it? Y'all know it? That's good old C-3PO.
That's right.
That little auto unit is in prime condition. Why should I stick my neck? Why should I stick my neck out for you? I don't know. You just remember this. I love those two. I'm so happy in Rise of Skywalker to have a lot more 3PO because he's annoying, but that's what makes him fun is how annoying he is in Empire Strikes Back. That's why we love him. He was the right level of annoying, unlike Jar Jar. Jar Jar, I still laughed at Jar Jar the first few times though. I still have some love for Jar Jar. I won't hate him entirely.
I feel bad for Jar Jar.
He gets... And kids loved him, and Ahmed Best was great at being Jar Jar.
Yeah, I got nothing against Ahmed.
I got nothing, so...
I like that they put him in episode 2, not to Jar Jar. I mean, he was there, but what I mean is Ahmed. He was a side character in the bar. And
I still haven't spotted him in there.
In that same scene is also Anthony Daniels.
Now, I haven't spotted him in any either.
Oh,
so
yeah.
I need to go look for him.
They're both in there. In that same scene where he's in there, you don't want to buy this stick. Yeah, it's in that same scene.
The Death Stick kid always looked familiar to me, but I can't think
like
who that
him,
is.
But yeah, I don't know who it is,
I've seen him in some other stuff, too.
But yeah, it's in that same scene where they kiss the bounty hunter or whatever. They're in there. So
I'll have to go look for him. There's so many people in that bar, though.
Oh, yeah, they've even made toys of him. Both of them.
Really? Okay, now that's awesome.
Yep.
Alrighty. Alright, so I got one last question on this card. Who's the first character to admit having a very bad feeling about this in A New Hope? That's a tough one. See, first person to say, I have a very bad feeling about this.
I think it's Luke, but I could be wrong.
I think you might be right, but I'm going to have to look it up. It is Luke!
All right,
and I think it's when they're going to the Death Star because it's like,
yes,
I have a bad feeling. I think you're right.
I thought it was, maybe you're right, but for some reason I was thinking it was when they went to the bar, wasn't it?
No, because Luke really didn't have much to say. He's already out of his depth going into Mos Eisley.
Yeah.
And he's keeping his mouth shut as best he can and trying to stay out of trouble. And he just tries to order a thing. And, tells the droid, we don't want any trouble. Luke knows, anybody here would probably kill him.
The problem is there's so many that line is like one of those lines that gets said so many times.
Yeah.
It gets confusing.
The second time, because I think it's in there at least twice, because there's the traction packer with Han going, I have a very bad feeling about this.
Yeah.
And he has that way to say that.
Very bad feeling.
Yes. Because it's not Star Wars unless you have a bad feeling
about
it.
And then Leia, she says that when you go into the belly of the, monster, whenever they go on the asteroid.
I have a bad feeling about this.
Because I got a very bad feeling about this. She's wearing the little mask.
I was even thinking about that, the radio dramas. I love the where somebody says, I have a bad feeling about this. And the guy playing Han Solo says, you get those too, huh?
Yeah.
I love it. I love it. I love it. The radio dramas are so good.
Yeah,
so good.
They're great.
Indeedy.
Okay.
I'm going to check our time here. We're still doing good. Y'all aren't getting tired of this, are you? We're having fun.
What youngster takes one look at R2-D2 and says, wow, a real astro droid? How did you get so lucky?
I don't know how the kid became so famous and everything, but everybody just loves Kickster.
That's Kickster.
Yeah.
Right.
Kickster or Kitster?
Kitster.
But I don't know. Rebel Force Radio has made a thing of Kitster somehow or another. Just, that kid, because he was, he, You could say he was a bad acting, but he's acting just like a kid would, which is what Jake Lloyd did. He acted as a kid would. He was just being a kid.
I feel sorry for the actual actor.
Yeah, I think he got dumped on too much.
He did a horrible job, but...
He acted exactly the way a kid would.
Yeah, he did an awful job. I think. But it's not his fault. They're the ones that chose him. He's not the one to be blamed, I mean, in my opinion.
I don't think that Hayden Christensen was a bad actor either. I think some of the script stuff he had was rough to work with. Okay. But Hayden Christensen, I think, is a pretty good actor. He got dumped on. Yeah. And his wife is gorgeous.
Yeah. I've never seen her.
Okay. Rachel Bilson from Chuck. She was the sandwich girl.
Oh,
she was on some other show, too. But I found out that she was married to Hayden Christensen. I was like, good job, Anakin.
I've seen him in other movies. He's a good actor. Mm-hmm. What's the one you have there?
Don't tell my wife I said that.
She's going to hear it. What's
she doesn't listen to the show.
What's a... Now she will.
But she's cute, though. And then she did those ice cream bar ads there for a while. She was doing those. Question for Phil. Who is Darth Vader talking to on the first Death Star when he observes he is here?
He's talking to Admiral Ackbar. Not Admiral Ackbar.
Yeah, but I'm going to take that back.
I meant to say, what's his name? Not Admiral.
Obi-Wan Kenobi. Are you sure?
Yeah, I can see him. Peter Cushing.
Yes, Peter Cushing.
For some reason, I can't think of
I'm sending it to you mentally. I'm using the Force. He's got a really grand title.
Oh, I love him. Oh, Grand Moff Tarkin.
There you go.
I don't know why I got saying Admiral, but Admiral, sorry.
And then you couldn't stop yourself. I saw it on your face. You started saying Admiral, and you couldn't stop it.
No, I couldn't say anything about Admiral. I guess because
and you had to follow with Ackbar because you couldn't stop.
Yeah.
It was. I wish I'd had this on camera.
You kept saying, it's a trap. It's a trap.
Because I know Lou Mangiello talked about, hey, he really thought that they should do this in the Galaxy Edge thing.
I love Peter Cushing, man. He was a great actor.
Oh, but like Lou Mangiello on WDW Radio has always joked that he wanted to have like a turkey wraps or something when they had a place that would be called It's a Wrap. To sell food would be fun.
Yeah, a seafood one.
Like a seafood wraps or something.
But then that'd be funny. Terrible. It's a wrap. It is a seafood thing. That'd be like eating Admiral Ackbar.
I wonder if anyone has done this. Maybe somebody has, but if nobody has done it, somebody should. Who can wrap and put a wrap group together, and they're like, and there'd be Star Wars aliens and have an Ackbar. It's a wrap.
Yeah. We went into battle and we couldn't find our place. We went into space.
How would they know that our shields are still up if they were jamming our radar signals? No. I'm white. I can't rap. I'm sorry. I'm very white, and I listen to classic rock. All right? I worked at a classic rock station. I have no business attempting to rap.
Okay, what's your question?
I'm more vanilla than ice. Okay? I am a cock casualty. Okay, enough of my fun. I think it is you to ask me, because you just answered Grand Moff Tarkin.
Let's see. You're right. What is Luke told he will be once Yoda dies?
The last of the Jedi will you be.
You are correct, sir.
Which now with some stuff they've done in Clone Wars, I feel like they've kind of messed that up a bit. I don't know. I haven't seen the finale of the final season of Clone Wars, but I mean, Ahsoka is still alive in Rebels. I haven't watched all of Rebels, though, either, to be honest. And I don't know whatever happens to the kid in there or, you know, there's other Force sensitive, you know, we've seen. So, well, Yoda maybe didn't know about the others, I guess. Because Luke would not have... Well, Luke might have been the only fully trained guy still alive. I don't know. Obviously, fully trained is the best you can get in maybe a couple of days. Well, of course, Luke was probably reading books and all kinds of stuff. He had a gap of time, so... But, yeah, they've kind of ruined that line now with some of the stuff they've done. With having some people that would be, you know, Jedi trained might still be alive.
Yeah.
So that's... when they get to some of that expanded universe, it always makes me nervous that they're going to ruin something of the original trilogy and make it where somebody lied again or something, you know. Anyway, where am I at here? Okay, here we go. Who uses Force lightning to toss Yoda across the room and against the wall? The far wall, in fact, it says.
If I'm not mistaken, that would be Emperor, which is also known as...
Yeah. Or Darth Sidious. Darth Sidious. Yeah. And that's where you find out just how powerful and scary Palpatine really is when he hits him with that lightning. Because we've seen already Yoda, like, blocking off, you know, Darth Tyrannus, you know.
Yeah, he can just...
Well, you know, with Count Dooku, as we know him, and he's just blocking up. And then when Sidious hits
almost
him...
Almost with nothing.
And at that zoom shot, you get into Yoda's face and the fear in Yoda's eyes, like, whoa! You know, and then, bam!
I love that scene because we never got to see... First of all, I could not stand the animatronic Yoda, or puppet, or whatever you want to call it, in that episode one. I hated that.
Yeah, they tried to make him look younger, and it didn't get it right.
Oh, you kidding?
It didn't look right.
He looked like Mr. Carlson from WKRP.
With big green ears?
Yeah, big green ears, you know.
I had never thought of that, but now I can't.
He did. He looked like Yoda.
Hey, man.
If you ever wonder, did you?
Wonder?
What became of me, did you?
Yes.
Living on the air since 90. Very Caribbean it is.
Yes. Wow. Okay. Hopefully someone's still listening after all of us. Okay.
Silliness.
Yes. All right. Next question for me.
Okay. Who gives the order to evacuate the remaining ground staff during the rebel retreat from Hoth?
That would be Leia Organa.
Princess Leia.
Yes. Okay, I guess she would still be a princess because she's always going to be a princess to me.
Yes. She'll always be our princess.
Indeed. Which, fun fact, the guy who gets to say that line, she'll always be a princess to me, played Jesus Christ once.
Ah.
And Max von Sydow, I'd forgotten, in The Greatest Story Ever Told, I believe it is, he played Jesus.
Ah, yeah. Awesome. I know that. I own that movie.
And then, of course, he even was...
I just bought it last year.
Flash Gordon. He was the bad guy.
Yes.
Ming. Ming the Merciless.
And he also played a kind of a sorcerer in a Carmen.
That was him in the one video. Oh, wow. Yeah,
that was him.
For anyone who knows who Carmen is besides us.
Yeah. Yeah.
That was him.
And
and he just died this year.
Yes, and
he had so much stuff. And, he even looked a little like Ming the Merciless still with the makeup and stuff.
You guys already know this, I'm sure, for you Star Wars fans. Also, right around that same scene when they came to talk to the princess to say that Han and Luke were out there, Cliff Clavin from Cheers,
John Ratzenberg there.
Yeah, yeah.
Not on Han.
And around that same time, he was also on Superman and Superman.
Yeah, 2. Yes, firing nuclear missiles.
Yep, and on Superman 2, he was working for NASA.
Yeah, firing off rockets.
Yep,
as usual.
Or
good old
delivering the mail.
Exactly.
The bus.
Yeah. Gotta love good old.
I love you, man.
Yes. Alrighty. So, all right. What character opens A New Hope with the question, "Did you hear that?"
Oh, that's C-3PO.
Yeah, it'd be nice if they gave you a hard question.
Oh, hey, I'm not that great at this stuff. I love it, but I couldn't get my mind all messed
up. Oh, we've watched these movies as the clip they played on Rebel Force Radio. I've seen Star Wars 500 times.
I love it.
Because we have, man.
Oh, man, I love that.
I used to have a videotape that had all three movies recorded onto it, and I would just start at night when I went to sleep, and I'd just let it play all through the night.
Just love it.
Just play the movies and so that it could be ingrained in my brain while I was trying to sleep.
I used to work out and run to the music over and over.
Oh, heck yeah, brother.
Still do, I can't. Okay, who starts his Death Star trench run by telling his wingmates, "We're going in full throttle"?
That's good old Luke Skywalker. We're going in full throttle. That'll keep those fighters off our backs. Luke, if that speed, we'll be able to pull out in time. He'll be just like Beggar's Canyon back home.
Oh, that's right.
One of the greatest pieces of music is the entire battle right there.
See how bad we are.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry for you're still listening, right? Okay, you're still with us. Oh man, what two humans are trapped in a room filling with lethal dioxys gas?
Say it again? I'm sorry to hear that.
What two humans are trapped in a room filling with lethal dioxys gas?
I think we're back to Obi-Wan and Qui-Gon, aren't we?
Yes, indeed we are, because they take a big force-driven hold of breath, and then One of the greatest entrances of two Jedis, other than just casually walking in, is when the droids open the door. They must be dead by now.
Yeah.
And there's nothing but fog and the two lightsabers. I love that!
That was cool.
Have you ever fought two Jedi before? No, but I threw off the bridge. So, I'm going to have to go. I'm going to watch me some Star Wars when I get home, man.
You get yourself all pumped up.
Yes! Because I still love these movies. Even episode one.
I still like it.
I still love it, you know. I mean, I went to episode, Heather and I, that was like our, we went to Dallas, but I mean, that's Heather and I, that one of the first things we ever did together before we were even dating was waiting in line for episode one tickets.
I saw it three times in the first day, so.
Well, I had to work that day, but we went, I don't even know how many times we went to go watch that movie.
What planet had the rebels used as a base before moving to the jungle moon of Yavin?
Dantooine, they're on Dantooine. We found remains of a rebel base, but it seems to have been abandoned for some time. She lied. She lied to us. I told you she would not have consciously betrayed the rebellion. Terminate her immediately.
You nut.
I'm a nerd. I freely admit. Okay. What treaded vehicles are shown crossing the Jundland Wastes?
Say it again.
What treaded vehicles are shown crossing the Jundland Wastes?
The Jundland?
The Jundland Wastes.
I'm not even sure what the Jundland.
And they have big treads on them. Really big treads and a really big vehicle. And they're slowly going across the Jundland Wastes, which are not to be traveled lightly. Yep.
I'm assuming we're talking about the... I can't think of the name of them right now. The Jawas.
You're on the right ballpark.
I can't think.
You know who's driving the thing, but...
I can't think of what they call it. We have the toilet of it. It was a remote control thing.
Oh, fun!
But this was, it was my cousin's, and then they gave it to us, and we used to, we had the little toys, Jawas in them, and,
Jawa.
And we'd keep them in there, and you could put all the little droids in it, and it would, it was awesome. You could take off the side of it, and you put all the little droids, keep them in there. And, but yeah, awesome. It was remote control. And yeah. But I say remote control, and it was, but this is, we're talking early days. You can look it up.
Like a Kenner thing.
Oh, it was... It was,
You know,
basically, barely forward, barely back. It was much to it.
Was it one of the ones where it went forward, and when it went backward, it would start to turn, and that's the only way you turn it?
Yeah, that's basically it. You know, man. How it was kind of roll back.
Yes.
Kind of forward. It wasn't that great.
God, I love it.
And I remember the little wire on top.
It
kind of bent, you know, it didn't do that great. Anyway, I want to say sandcrawler. That can't be right.
Yes, it is.
Is it right?
It is a sandcrawler.
Oh, man.
Right toe. And the left toe, too.
What's that?
I said right toe and the left toe, too. I'm funny, okay? I'm funny.
What color is Queen Amidala's gown during the celebration marking the liberation of Naboo?
I believe that was like a white. Was like, it didn't have some gold trim and stuff on it.
It just says white.
Just says
but
white.
I think you're correct.
I'm pretty sure she had some gold trim and everything. And they had the white makeup and stuff like that. They came up with some really kind of weird and wild things for her to wear that looked really kind of cool.
Let's see here.
You could definitely see the kabuki influence on some of it, though, that's for sure.
Oh, absolutely.
Definitely.
They had some Japanese
Yeah, that's what I mean with the kabuki. Yeah,
a little bit of Chinese stuff.
She was almost like a little porcelain doll at times because they would put the tiny little lips.
They did. And I love how they were very smart because they didn't just pick one type of from one, you know, race or whatever. They take three or four and I love it because it's not supposed to be from this world.
Yeah.
So they would take all, and then they take stuff from, you know, sci-fi, and it was great. I loved it.
Was that last question on your
it
card
sure
there?
Was.
All right, we're going to call that enough from your card. So one last question for you because we got to wrap this show up. So, who retains his position in the Trade Federation despite four trials in the Supreme Court?
One more time.
Who retains his position in the Trade Federation despite four trials in the Supreme Court? Yeah, it is who I thought it was.
Oh,
but it's one of those tough names because I don't know if they say it necessarily out loud.
Oh, man. You know what? I honestly don't know that.
You might.
I might, but...
Can you at least tell me what race he is? What species?
What species?
Right? Yeah.
Probably more...
But they mention him being tried in the second movie when you see him again, and you know he's still they got his position, even though he was tried four times in between episodes one and two, apparently,
oh, so
for their crimes in the first movie.
So it must be... Okay. See, I'm trying to think, because for some reason I'm not really... it has to be Jar Jar Binks.
Well, no.
No.
I can try to hint you.
I'm assuming it's one of the... I can see them, but I can't think of the name. I can't think of the name of their species.
Spock was rather fond of them.
Not the Vulcans.
Well, not Vulcans, because,
that's a Star Trek.
Because Leonard Nimoy.
Nimoy.
And if Leonard Nimoy had a country and people were from that, they would be called this.
I can't think of it, man.
Nimoidians. That's what they were. They were the Nimoidians. And they were, their trade federation was led by a name who, well, you're not a big Monty Python fan, but in the Holy Grail, a guy claimed he got turned into one of these, but I got better. And that's the first name.
I don't remember. You just tell me.
Newt Gunray.
Newt Gunray, that's right.
Yes.
I know the
name.
He
was a Nimoidian, head of the Trade Federation. And even the guy with him, who was second command, I forgot what his name was already, dang. But I used to know his name, too.
They had really big heads. They're
weird. Huge. They're Pope hats. They're Pope hats.
Kind of a Pope-looking hat. Yeah.
All right, I'm going to turn these this direction. Because I'm trying to make
this sure must have come up. Out after episode one and before episode two, I'm assuming.
No, this is Saga. This was all six.
Oh, it was all six. Oh,
all
okay.
six,
but I didn't hear anything about the episode three.
Yeah, well, I don't think we got a single question. That was episode three.
Did we get about episode two?
Yes, we had lots of episode two. We had Jango Fett questions.
Oh, yeah, duh.
All over the place.
I
just asked you an episode two question because they mention it like, you know.
Two or three, duh.
He still gets to be in there. But anyways, I hope you're having fun on May the 4th. We've had fun preparing for it, and I'm going to watch me some Star Wars.
I'm going to watch some of the Clone War cartoons.
I need to catch up.
The great thing about having Disney Plus is that you can have just about any kind of Star Wars thing you want.
And that's why Disney loves me and my show, because we keep promoting Disney Plus to them. Because I've seen people on YouTube videos trying to claim Disney Plus is a failure. I'm like, failure what? I'm watching it all the time.
It's people watching.
Bunch of people watching. Because especially since they put New Adventures in Winnie the Pooh.
Oh, yeah.
I watch that show all the time on Saturday morning. I love watching that again.
But
watching some Disney Afternoon shows.
Saturday morning.
Got to get up and got to get going. I got to see a friend of mine.
Yep, that's it.
He's round and he's fuzzy, and I love him because he's just Pooh Bear.
And not just that, we also have Hulk Hogan on that show. Because he's the one who, believe it or not, he was the voice of Eeyore.
Oh, because in the cartoon Hulk Hogan. Yeah, Brad Garrett was Eeyore. And
he was Hulk Hogan.
No, wait. That was not Brad Garrett. That was Optimus Prime.
Oh, that's right.
Right. Brad Garrett. Remember we actually ran into this thing. Yeah, Brad Garrett got to do the movie because someone asked him about Eeyore. So, well, heck, I am Eeyore. But not because he'd ever voiced it. It's just he was so close in personality to Eeyore. But they got him to voice Eeyore because of that.
Yeah.
Because he is a perfect Eeyore in the film Christopher Robin. But no, it was actually...
He did.
Optimus Prime. I can't think of the guy's name.
He has done Eeyore before in the cartoon.
He has done it.
Yeah.
Because we came across this because you were so sure, but we came across that he had never actually done it.
He has done Eeyore.
I'm going to look it up.
According to him, he's done Eeyore.
Because he had said it, well, heck, I am Eeyore, but I think he meant it because in personality. But I think, because I remember we came across that thing and we were like, wait a minute.
He said he has done Eeyore.
All righty, I'm going to look up his IMDb. And you thought the show was over.
Yeah. They hoped. I think they hoped it was over.
They hoped. Well, one last thing, but because...
According to him.
Let's rewind back here. Christopher Robin, and we know he was Eeyore there.
Yeah, of course.
Because he is a perfect voice for
Eeyore. Well, he's done so many voices, and he does have a great voice.
I'm
very
going back.
Strong.
Going back. Well, there's a Winnie the Pooh right there. Now, this is a 1966? Winnie the Pooh and the Honey Tree. Well, they got Brad Garrett listed in that. He wasn't in...
No, he wasn't in that one.
Yeah, I think this is a boo-boo.
No, he wasn't boo-boo. Can you imagine?
There's a fandom here for... There's a Winnipedia. Would you believe this? A Winnipedia.
A Winnipedia?
Well, it's part of fandom's Wikipedia thing. You got Fatso and the Uncle of Casper. I remember that.
Yes. He was, of course, the...
I forgot he was Krang.
Yeah.
And the Ninja Turtles Out of the Shadows.
Sure was.
Yeah. Animated storybook Winnie the Pooh and the Honey Tree. So he did an animated storybook.
Yes.
Oh, this well, he will be reprising his role as Eeyore in Christopher Robin 2018 films. This needs to be updated. But so he had done Eeyore before as a voice, but yep. It was an animated storybook. It wasn't an actual series yet. Because I remember we bumped into that at one point. But yeah. Because Optimus Prime is Eeyore in the cartoon, which he was a great Eeyore too. Yeah,
of course.
Yeah.
We have a lot of Eeyores.
Oh, and that's another thing. We keep getting messed up, and I keep forgetting I wanted to fix because we keep getting this up. The difference between character type and a character actor. Mm-hmm. Character type is what we were talking about the one time before. A character type is a John Wayne. He's yes. a type of a character. But a character actor is somebody like Johnny Depp or even like me who chameleons into stuff. Because
yeah.
I have to completely get my head into a character and I always have a voice for it. But that's a character actor is someone who's chameleon and a character type, which is a character type is where your leading man's going to be. A character actor is seldom a leading man. And even if you look yeah. like Johnny Depp, he's not. If he's a leading man, he plays it straight. But most of the time, he's a supporting character, but he's an over-the-top, like Captain Jack Sparrow, yeah, or even...
And that's a character...
I like him as Grindelwald. I don't know why everybody crapped on that second movie. He was a really good Grindelwald in that second movie.
So he's a character...
He's a character actor, and then there's a character type, which is where they want a type. And that's usually where you get your...
Don't nod to me.
Yeah, he's definitely a type. Yeah, but that's where you get your leading men is your character type because they want a certain type of person. So that's when you get your John Wayne, you get your Jimmy Stewarts.
I've seen
the guys are just perfect for that.
Certain movie. I've seen a special about that one time. It was really funny. I can't remember the actor's name right now.
And you thought the show was over.
He was on a movie, one of my favorite movies, Groundhog Day. And he was the one who played, he goes,
yes.
Ned that hit.
Ned! Goes, yes!
There was a movie where
I can't think of his name now.
Yeah, he's great. He's been on a million things.
Yes.
They was looking for his type.
Type.
But yes. he went into Triport and they wouldn't hire him.
Oh.
And that was hilarious.
And like Brad Garrett is actually very much a good type because he's got that tone and that way he speaks.
Timber, yeah.
Yes, Timber. Actually, it's supposed to be like, I've had to learn this in audio. It looks like timber, but it's like tomber.
Tomber, really?
I don't know why you pronounce it that way, though.
Yeah.
I've always wanted to ask that whenever we get into that, but it looks like timber, except for it's R-E.
Timber!
But it's, you switch your R-E and becomes tomber.
Well, either way,
I've got a degree in this stuff, and I still don't understand why we call it that. I don't know. But sound is a wonderful thing.
That's right.
And you know the difference between sound and noise?
No,
sound is something you've controlled, and even if it sounds hideous, you've controlled it to be that way. Noise is an uncontrollable, like, if a bunch of stuff just suddenly randomly fell over and we had no control over it, that's noise. But if you push something over on purpose to get the type of sounds you wanted for that in Foley, then that's sound.
I see.
Who knew, right? That's ridiculous.
I've met some people who you can't tell the difference.
But that's why you said, when you hear something and some random thing happened, you should say, well, what was that noise?
Yeah.
Because if a sound implies it was a controlled thing that you meant.
Yes. Okay.
I know. There's the stuff I learned in college, right? I learned a lot of stuff in college that I didn't know was supposed to be a thing, like timbre and noise.
And we paid money for
this. I paid money to learn this. I'm still paying for it, too. I have student loans like you wouldn't believe. Okay, and with that, now the show really is over. Roll them credits.
Thank you for listening to the Neverland Podcast.
We invite you back next week for more fun and adventure.
Until then, remember to keep a pixie in your pocket.
It's that young at heart, positive attitude that you can share with others.
And remember to visit our website at neverlandpodcast.com.
There you can find links to our news page, our shop,
our contact page, where you can easily send an email to podcast@neverlandpodcast.com.
You can also find our Neverlanders page, where you can find out how to become an official Lost Boy or Pixie, because girls are too clever to get lost.
Become a real Neverlander.
Please feel free to leave us a voicemail at 816-226-6492.
And be sure to follow us on Twitter at NeverlandPCast.
And like our Neverland Podcast fan page on Facebook.
We also have a group on Facebook for you to join.
We also appreciate your support to keep the Neverland Podcast up and running.
Visit patreon.com/NeverlandPodcast to donate to keeping the pixie dust alive.
Copyright content featured on the Neverland Podcast is copyright of their respective creators and used under fair use license.
All original content is copyright of Blue Band Productions And a very special thanks to Yeehaw Bob Jackson at yeehawbob.com for our new ending music.
God bless.
Yeah! Hello, everybody. This is Yeehaw Bob Jackson. Neverland Podcast, we love you. Neverland Podcast, we love you. Neverland Podcast, it's true. Neverland Podcast, we love you.